If you were alive and owned a radio in the 1950s, then you know about Chuck Berry. If you weren't alive then, you still know about Chuck Berry. He has been around for a long, long time. For those who know rock and roll, the songs that Chuck helped memorialize, he wrote them, Maybelline, Roll Over Beethoven, Johnny Be Good. Those are legendary sounds, and that's the original rock and roll. The thumping bat beats and the driving rhythms are hard to find in current pop music, and yet the revival of early rock and roll, it's still interesting, and it still has a huge, huge following because it's the real thing, isn't
it? It's basic, yeah. It's basic music, simple. At least I hope it to be.
Yeah.
My music is, anyway.
Are you surprised 20 years ago, well, more than 20 years ago, when you were writing Maybelline and whatnot, that there'd still be an audience 20 years later?
Well, you know, it's so fascinating in the beginning that you don't think of 20 years from now, you know. I didn't think of how it would be now.
That famous duck walk that you are doing there, where did that come from? Why?
Well, you know, when I was a kid, I used to, like, scoot under the table, and whenever company would come around, you know, well, my sisters or parents would tell me, go under the table, you know, and I'd do it, you know. It was like an entertainment for the family, or aunts or whatever. And one time at the Paramount, it was, when I first did it, Brooklyn Paramount, I did it in the act on an instrumental and played my guitar, and I got a big ovation, so I coined it as one of the things I should do in the act. And since, I've been doing it.
You just don't do it under tables anymore.
You're right.
Yeah. A lot of people might wonder, look at Chuck Berry performing on stage. You are, I think I can say this affectionately, a crazy man on the stage.
Crazy legs, I've been called.
Yeah.
By the way, I appreciate that founding fathers. You know, there's been so many empires, kings are kind of going out of style.
Yeah.
I'm so glad.
Thank you.
Yeah, right.
Thank you. I mean, I'm not the source authority for the founding fathers, but. I'll take the thanks anyway. But I don't know who else. Who would you say is the founding father of rock and roll, if not yourself?
Well, it's not for me to say, but I'm surely a cog in the wheel, as my pop used to say. Yeah, cog in the wheel.
Okay, who are some of the other cogs, though?
Well, here, I'll say Domino, and I'll say Louis Jordan, and Elvis Presley, and even Fats Waller, because Fats played basic music. Yeah, Fats Waller, yeah. And that host of a Little Richard, he's great. He was great in the beginning. Bill Haley was, you know. So, I mean, we're all just, I think, a cog in the wheel. We all got the ball rolling.
That ball's been rolling now for, I don't need to tell you, 20-odd years.
Thank you.
Who's performing it best today, other than yourself, because you are still very, very much an active performer?
Yes and no. I work a couple of days a week now, and I pretty much choose the jobs, thank you. But, you know, I have so many entities now. As you grow older, you gain responsibilities, you know, real estate, and I like video. And I want to live a little, you know, because time is passing. It's not as long as it has been. I want to see some of the world. I haven't been to Hong Kong yet, for instance. So I'm not, I'm writing as best I can in order to keep the momentum in the career there, you know. But I want to live.
Yeah. Well, nobody's pulling the curtain down on your career by any means, but it has been a long one. There have been high times, of course, and there have been hard times, too. On balance, what kind of a career has it been?
Well, I would say exciting and far above my expectations. I had no idea. They told me Maybelline might last 2 years. I had disbelief in that. And before Maybelline died away, there was Roll Over Beethoven, School Days, Wheel of 16, and so forth, and it has perpetuated and continued until and through now. So it's far above my expectations.
Maybelline be a middle-aged lady by now, and she's still shaking.
Well, Sweetie 16 is 34 now.
Yeah. The Beatles and the Rolling Stones are stepchildren of yours in a way. They will give Chuck Berry a lot of credit. Are you kind of proud of those kids?
I am. I am very much. And, of course, I don't quite understand, if I may go on further, some of the new coins that have been like, acid rock came in there not too long ago, but this new thing, I think they call punk rock. Yeah. And I haven't even got in far enough to, you know, I think these names are the character of the Deliverance, because music is music, you know. You can't change rock and say this is punk rock, or this is acid rock, or this is hard rock, or rockabilly. Music's music, and I think the people are the actors who, the musicians, when they put the music out, they want to insert their character in it. So they call it such and such, so that you put the adjectives in it, so that you'll know what they or how they live, so to speak. Yeah. But rock is rock, and rock and roll is rock is just short for rock and roll. I've been asked this, and I think this is my opinion of it. You know. Yeah. So when we say when we put all the adjectives in front of it, if they're playing basic music, it's just rock.
Mm-hmm. How old are you now?
51.
You're 51, mm-hmm. and you're still a rocker yourself.
Oh, yeah, I can boogie a little bit.
Yeah. I've heard, I think I know the answer to this question already, but who was the greatest singer of all time, in your opinion?
There are two.
There are two? Who?
Nat and Frank Sinatra.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, believe me. Because I'm emotional, and I think they arouse more emotion in me than any, you know, yeah. than any other. And if I may add, Muddy Waters, Louis Jordan, Benny Goodman, of course, Glenn Miller's, you know, band music. These are the inspirers of mine.
Yeah.
Yeah, these are the ones who influenced me. Yeah. And they still live in my books. Matter of fact, I'm playing them every day. They call it rock, you know.
Well, enough people are playing the works of Chuck Berry. I suppose you can do some borrowing on your own. Thank you for being with us. You're a delight.
It's a pleasure.
A delight offstage, too.